So in this lesson we will see how to start Git, create a new repository, and basic use of Git, like initialize a new project, clone an existing project from GitHub, and do some commits, and at the end fork and pull a request. And that means how to collaborate with other people on existing projects. Version control system means that when you work, you can memorize the history of your work. So you can, when you perform some modification of your code, you can go back for the bug, or because you decide that the new development is not useful for you. Furthermore, with Git you can collaborate with other people, so when someone makes some modification, you can track them in all your history. Here you can find the instruction to install Git on Linux, Mac and Windows, and how to set up the Git for the first time on your machine. Then when you have installed Git on your machine, you have to create an account on GitHub, because Git is on your local machine. GitHub is a sort of cloud that uses Git to track the history of your project. So in this picture we can see that you have your working directory where you work. The modifications are added to a staging, an index, and when you decide that these modifications are fine, you can memorize in the history of your project. That is, perform a commit on your local repository. So far you can use Git without GitHub, but all your history is memorized on your machine, so if your machine breaks down, you're using your work. So the idea is to couple Git with GitHub in order to have a remote repository that maintains all your history, and from which you can have always access. So if you change your machine, you can take the project from GitHub, work on the new machine, make your modification, push all the modification on remote repository, and start to work again on your previous machine or another one. So there is the local history and the remote history. This is fundamental to keep in mind. This is how to initialize the existing project. These are the comments that you have to do. Then you can create a repository on GitHub where you can put all your code, your project. And when you have performed some modification and you have committed to your local machine, local repository, you have to push to the remote repository. How Git works, it explained by this graph. In green, this is what is usually called the master, that is the main line of your work. From this main line, you can have some branches that are some derivation in which you want to cope with a specific target task. You commit on these branches when you think that your work is okay. You can go back to the master with a merge. That is the red arrow. When your work has reached an interesting the coder, that is the blue square, T1. So you assign a name to this version of the code that you can always have access to this one by the tag name. To work with the Git, you have two possibilities. One is to start from a bare project on your machine. Otherwise, you can copy an existing project from GitHub. When you copy, means that you just take a copy of the project from GitHub to your local machine, but this project is not under your GitHub ID. So if I have a project and Concetta cloned my project, she has a copy of my project, but the project is not in her GitHub account. There is another possibility, that is to have a fork on the project. That means I have my project on my account, Concetta forks it, so she has a copy of my project on her account, on GitHub account, and this project lives only on her GitHub account. If she wants to have it on her machine, she has just grown it from her GitHub account. And this is the way that you can collaborate with other people. Because when she forks from my project, she can ask and make some modification. She can ask me to add this modification to my project. And this is the pull request. This pull request means that she asked me and I can control her modification and I can accept them before to merge with my repository. This is a graph that a picture that represents this. We have in red. This is the original project. Alice created a fork of this project. That is this one. She cloned this project on her local machine. Eventually, she can, let's say, pull from the official project. That means take all the new modification that has done in the original project on her local machine. She can push to her remote repository, but if she wants to push to the original one, she has to perform a pull request. And the owner of this official repository can check for conflicts and at the end can accept the request. Okay, that's all. There are some slides to where I can explain the instruction to work with Git, but I don't have my machine, so.